Thank you.
This is really it.
Yes. I can't live like this any longer. Goodbye, I'm sorry.
Yeah, those five students from Stanford are all listed in fair condition at General Hospital.
Anything new worth printing?
No, nothing new.
What about...
Morning, Inspector.
Sterling?
You've got something to say to me, O'Neill.
No, nothing important, but I...
Whatever you've got to say can be bought for the price of your newspaper.
I'm sorry, Sterling. I know it hollow to say I'm sorry, but... But, Sterling, what else can I say? I am sorry.
Don't bother about that small stuff. You have a future in front of you. I've chosen you to write my life story. You can start it like this. When I first knew him, he didn't have a cent to his name. Hey, lend me 20 cents. Otherwise, I'll be poor man. Is the old man inside?
Your father's speaking to Sterling.
Now I know why you're waiting outside.
If I hadn't been waiting out here with you, you wouldn't be able to finish your story.
Well, if I don't finish this one, I'll give you another one. Much more exciting. See ya.
You know, it would have been better if you'd have gotten out of town. Come on, don't worry, Sterling. We'll find those hoods. And then you'll be right back at your desk where you belong. We're gonna catch them eventually.
I'm sure you will. And I'm staying right here in town to help you. And here, you might as well take this. Belongs to you like everything else around here.
You know, what you're doing is completely insane.
I'm sure it is. But it's the only thing I've got left to do.
I'm sorry, Sterling.
Thanks, Gary.
Gary, come in here. I want to see you.
I know, Father, what you have to tell me. I'm sorry, but I didn't pay the insurance.
I don't want to hear about you being sorry. I want to hear what you did with the money. And don't tell me you used it to pay off the other premiums, because I know you didn't.
Well, I need money.
If you need money, go out and get a job. You're old enough. I'm glad your mother didn't live long enough to see you like this. Well... Probably my fault. I wasn't a very good father.
Suffered enough for you? What more do you want from us? Are you trying to destroy everything we ever had together? Every day, every night, I see you going out, following them. Why torment yourself this way? You can't prove your innocence. Nobody will believe you anymore, no matter if you could find the man responsible for it.
I have to understand it first.
What are you trying to do? You're not a detective anymore. And besides, you know what people are saying. They're saying that you really killed that man. Are you still trying to prove your innocence? Are you still trying to catch them in the act? Let's leave. We'll go away to a new city where nobody knows us. We'll start a new life together, the three of us.
This will be the last time for us. I got something to ask you.
You know I don't like visitors here.
I know, but you owe me a favor. And I'm looking for a guy named Joe Randolph.
No bread, baby. Save your money. The Mayfair Hotel.
The house, Dick.
Something wrong?
Now, how could that be? You're here, aren't you? Well, everything's all right. I just want to know something about one of your tenants.
What's his name?
Randolph. Joe Randolph.
Never heard of him.
Still, I believe that he lives here.
I don't have much of a memory for names.
You know this guy?
I don't stand around here all day watching who goes in and out. And I don't have any memory for faces.
Look, pal. We make a lot of enemies in our racket. And friends sometimes can be useful, especially in business.
You say business? How much?
$100 for doing practically nothing. Just the number of the room. Then you can go right back to sleep. Okay?
Ah. Room 408.
A room. I want a room.
We'll pull up. Try somewhere else.
Randolph sent me.
Randolph? Who would that Randolph be? I don't know nobody by that name.
I want a room on the fourth floor. Next to Randolph.
Fourth floor, room 407. $10 a day in advance.
Inspector Sterling? Rocky couldn't come. He asked me to bring you. Something important to tell you.
Don't you, Rocky?
Something I want to talk to you about. How about Wednesday at 8? Is that all right? Good. Okay, I'll see you then. So long. I'm in golf, and I got a 78. Don't drop the phone. I said a 78. Are you panicked? You're shaking. Well, listen, don't be panicked. It can happen to you, too. What do you mean I'm playing it cool?
Just a 78. Next time I'll be better.
Sure.
Hey, why not?
I sound what?
Hello.
Al? Hey, how are you? I'm fine, thanks. Say, you've been on vacation. You
don't
tell me about
make
it.
A sound.
What? I'm great.
Well, let's take a look at your room. Now turn on the light. You look nervous. It's just a meeting between friends. Now get in the bathroom and turn on the light. Turn on the light. Open a faucet. You do that one more time, and I'll fill you full of holes. Now start getting undressed. The way you do it every night. And put your clothes where you put them every night. That's right. Exactly where you put them every night. Now, come over here. Sit down. You're going to start writing. Randolph, who would you think of writing to if you knew that you were going to die?
To my mother in Illinois. She's a poor old woman. She's taking care of the kids. I have two. The boy's name is George.
Ah.
The girl's Martha. They're still little. My wife died when the girl was born. And ever since, they've been with my mother.
That your mother?
This your daughter. What about this one? You're a very good family man. Marvelous father. It shows great, wonderful sentiment. It does you a lot of credit.
It's true. It's true.
You were never married. You never had any children. And you never had a mother.
It's true. I have two. One's George, and the other's Martha. It's true. I swear it. I swear it. I swear. I swear. It's the truth.
Someone with more brains than you gives the orders. Now Rocky knew who that was, and Rocky was killed. Who killed Rocky? Open up!
I'm entitled to a phone call. I want a lawyer. It's my right.
Okay, Kelly. You want to tell me who killed Rocky? I want to know now. Now!
You know damn well, copper, it was you. We're entitled to a lawyer. That's the only way we're going to talk.
I want to know.
Oh,
now!
Sterling, come on. Sterling.
I'm sorry, Don.
Nobody hit me. I don't remember anybody hitting me. That's a new kind of third degree.
And you swore to a lie. Now, you write exactly what I tell you. I, Joseph Randolph, committed perjury. Right. Get up. Get up and go on the bed. Now grab that bottle of booze. Without the glass, now drink. Drink. That's it. Now drop the bottle. Lie down. Lie down. Give me the pillow. The pillow. All right. Put your head down.
No.
Look at the light in the ceiling.
All right. I'll tell you everything you want to know. It was a lie. But don't kill me.
Now get up and start writing. Get up. Now, you write exactly what I told you before. Write down who Charlie is and who killed Rocky. The whole setup. And what happened that night.
call the police department. Randolph is dead.
It's the truth, Judge. I swear. That's the whole story, and it's true. We were playing cards when Sterling came in. He didn't allow us to say anything. He beat us. He was holding a gun. There was a shot, and Rocky was dead.
According to police reports, the bullet was fired from a .38 caliber police revolver at very close range. There were fingerprints found on the weapon, and those fingerprints were Lieutenant Sterling's. Now, we knew that Lieutenant Sterling had an appointment with Rocky, who was one of his most important informers. But personally, I do not believe that Lieutenant Sterling killed him.
Yes, Your Honor, he beat us because he didn't want us to tell the truth.
That night, he beat us. See the marks?
I swear it. Yeah, see that? I swear.
This one, and this one, and this.
I swear it.
And this one.
I swear it.
And this one.
I swear it.
And this one.
I swear it.
O'Neill, tell that photographer if he takes my picture again, I'll break his jaw.
What do you know about this?
Everything. Except the name of who killed him.
Do you have anything to do with it?
I didn't want a corpse, I wanted a witness. I got here too late.
There are no fingerprints on the gun except Randolph's. However, this isn't the gun that killed him. No, this one. The bullet came from a .32 automatic.
You know, when you think you found a suspect, you're supposed to call the police. Now, you know that, but you didn't do it, did you?
It could have been you that found him. Same as I did. I didn't have time to call.
You sure those are the only fingerprints on those weapons? You better check them over again.
Sterling? Now you can spend your dime. Tomorrow you'll read something about yourself.
You reporters need your garbage, don't you? So that your rag can be sold even to the village idiots. You need headlines. Policeman is killer. Murders in cold blood.
It's my job. And it isn't any dirtier than yours.
Well, I want to tell you something. I want to tell you a story. Or better yet, the same story from a different angle. If crime goes up, you say it's the cop's fault. He's too soft. That's what you write in your newspaper. But if for once a policeman gets a confession, you're against it. There's always someone to be sorry for in your articles, the criminal. And when the policeman testifies in court, well, then you say he can't even speak English. And then once again, the criminal is coddled. But if the policeman kicks up a complaint about it, well, then he can consider himself lucky to be in a beat picking up drunk off the gutter or having a hooker spit in his face.
That's a hard luck story of an ex-policeman. Nobody's interested in that.
Now, who do you work for? Somebody warned Randolph before he came upstairs. Now, he took 3 minutes longer than he should have. And he was ready with a gun.
That's the porter. I know nothing about it.
Somebody phoned the man that killed him. It was you, wasn't it?
It was Randolph. He was the one who told him.
Now, what was the number?
I don't know. I swear I don't. All I know is that he called someone before he went upstairs.
Listen. Randolph made a phone call. What was the number?
Tell him.
Come on, hurry up.
Thank you. Change. Are you ready? All right, good, another. Look up, look up. Good, fine, another. That's it? Yes, yes, oh, good, good. One more. Intellectual. Now, Janet, what's the matter with you this morning? Pay attention, intellectual. Yes, that's good. Another. No, no, no. Supplicate, prayer, that's it.
Someone who's been following me all day. I'm really scared. Okay. Bye. He didn't follow me. I don't know who he was or what it was he wanted from me. Please come quickly. I'm scared. Please come.
Hello. Hello.
Who are you? What do you want?
The name is Sterling. Charlie would have known.
How did you get into my house? Get out. I'm going to call the police.
Go ahead. I don't think it'll do your career any good if the police find out that Randall phoned you before he was killed.
I don't know what you're talking about. What do you want?
You knew Randall. I want you to tell me who killed him. Was it Kelly? Was it Charlie? You know them.
What makes you think I know them?
Here's your friend, Kelly. You knew Randolph. I want to know who killed him. Was it Kelly or Charlie? You know them.
You must be crazy or completely drunk. Do I know Kelly? Of course. There's Gene Kelly, Mayor Kelly. There are thousands of Kellys in America, and even more Charlies. Most of them are listed in the phone book, and I suggest you look there.
I might do that. It'll pass the time while I wait for Charlie.
Listen, if you're a cop, let me see your warrant. You can't break into a nice girl's house like this and put those down.
This doesn't prove it.
No, give me that.
All right. What do you want? Is it blackmail? Money? Okay, how much do you want? How much?
You always write your own lines. Your act is lousy. Father wouldn't be too happy to see you here. He doesn't like this place.
And what would be the right place for me? Watching juvenile delinquents pass through the police station? What a drag you are.
Well, there are other jobs besides being a policeman.
But anyway, it's none of your business, is it?
You're right. Hey, Bob. I want to find a couple of guys.
Ah, today was rough. Too many people, too much work. I don't know. When I'm tired, I don't have a good memory. I don't know anything.
Kelly and Charlie, but especially Charlie.
I've never seen them, never heard of them.
Ever seen this?
No, I don't know anything about that anymore. I don't have anything to do with that stuff now.
What's behind that door?
Nothing. We don't play that scene anymore here. But Sterling, it's closed.
most seen, right, Bobby? Tell Kelly that I'm looking for him.
Important to tell Sterling?
That right?
Lucky!
Don't try it, baby. Now, Rocky wants to tell you something. Something about Charlie.
Don't try it again, baby, or it's all over.
Time since we've met, hasn't it, Kelly? Don't move, or this time I'll blow your head off. All right, now, get out.
You can't kill me. I haven't got a gun. I'm unarmed. You'd be killing a defenseless man. You can't get away with it.
I don't want to kill you. I just want to talk to you privately. Police methods were a little too soft for you.
I don't know nothing.
Now you're going to tell me the truth. Someone gave you your orders. Someone ordered Rocky killed so they could put the blame on me. And then you had a free hand in knocking over the factory. You testified in court and you won.
I don't know nothing.
Now, I want you to tell me what happened that day. That holiday.
Oh,
set me up? Who set me up?
You'll never find out, copper.
Who told you I was the only one that could testify against you?
He's been dead, would you say?
Several hours, sir.
All right, get him out of here. All right, move him out.
All right.
You heard him. Clear him out.
Let's move back.
Clear him out.
Keep it clear. Now move back, please. Move back, come on. Let's move back. Let's go home.
You want to tell me about it?
I already told you.
A man is dead, Sterling, and you killed him.
In self-defense.
You had it all planned, didn't you? Provocations, witnesses.
Self-defense.
Self-defense. But it's not a defense. First, you're going to have to explain to me why the two men who testified against you were killed when they were with you. And you're going to have to repeat it and repeat it and repeat it until I know it by heart. The whole thing. Word for word. Sergeant!
Yes, sir.
Take him down to the station.
Right. Come on.
Everything according to regulations.
Just following the rules, Sterling. You know this is the way we question all murder suspects.
Everything according to regulations. Right, Donald?
Well, let me tell you something. You can't always go according to the book. Because that day, I was going to find out why that trap was set for me. Then they came, robbed the factory. But you weren't there. There was no law there at all. Only me. I phoned you so that you could follow them and find out who their leader was. But you had the squad cars turn on the sirens full blast. Like the book says, right, Donald? The sirens stepped them off. So they ran for it. What could I do to stop them? I was just an ex-cop. My hands were tied. Oh, you made a great impression on the citizens as your boys were burning rubber, playing cops and robbers all over the town. Sure, for you it was just a standard police operation, according to the rules.
They're your rules. And I won't forgive you that mistake. And you know why. Because after that, you know what happened. And you know why I couldn't quit after that.
Supposing you answer my question.
Suppose you answer mine. Who told Randolph and Kelly that I had spotted them? And who told them that I was the only one that could testify against them? Who told them, Donald? You were the only one that knew.
What are you trying to say? If you got something to say, say it.
The time isn't right. But when it is, I will. And then Charlie won't have long to live. As far as I'm concerned, you can put down self-defense.
Put down that the suspect was uncooperative, and I suggest the case be turned over to the district attorney's office. Put that back! You're not on the force anymore. You don't have a permit to carry a weapon. You know the law. All right, Corelli, lock him up.
With or without it, I'll find Charlie, or whoever calls himself Charlie.
Mm-hmm.
Well, that takes care of everything as far as the law is concerned. But if it was up to me, I'd leave him right here. Okay, Sterling, you're free. But if you get caught a second time, there's no bail, you understand? And stop acting like you're still on the force, because you're not. And that's against the law, and you know it. Sterling, we'll catch the real criminal, and we'll do it ourselves. So stop butting in, will you? We'll catch him. Okay?
With or without you, I'll get Charlie.
Want to lift, Sterling?
Yeah. My car's in front of the Ark.
You know, Sterling, I believed it. It was you who killed that kid, Rocky. Now, I've changed my mind.
That's your hang-up.
I was tough on you, but it's my job. I hate violence. Ah, stop acting tough, Sterling. You're in trouble right up to your eyeballs, and you could use a friend. You know, I'm a funny guy. When everybody says it's sunny, I go out and buy an umbrella, and vice versa. Well, about Rocky's death, I started to look into the other side of the matter. And I asked myself, why did Randolph and Kelly persist in accusing you of killing that boy?
You wrote it yourself. Rocky wanted money for his information. I wouldn't pay. So he got tough and I killed him.
Rocky Finney, a young clerk in a real estate agency who leads a very normal life. Now, suddenly he feels a need to give out a bit of information. Do you suppose anyone's interested?
You remember the address of the real estate agency?
Myers Real Estate Agency, on Market Street.
Thanks for the information. And for the lift.
Sure.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Please have a seat.
Thank you.
Thank you. I'm Inspector Wilson of Homicide. I want some information on a tenant of yours. Janet Mell, 26 Regency Street. Oh, yes, Miss Mell. One moment. Please send me in the files on 26 Regency Street. She's been living in one of our apartments and has been there for around 6 months. It's very prompt with her payments. Thank you. Could I see the lease? Of course. Excuse me. Yes? No, and hold all the calls for the moment, please. Yes, thank you.
Did Rocky Finney ever work here?
Yes, he was a fine employee. Say, could you show us a plan of the apartment? Certainly. Would you send in the plan for the apartment at 26 Regency Street?
Last time I was here, I won a nice bundle.
You know you're not supposed to bet on these cars. Did you finish your novel yet?
I haven't decided on the end yet.
Don't you have a deadline with your publisher?
Well, don't worry, Pop. I'll work it out.
body's been found at Pier 3 on the naval base.
Hold us.
Documents identify the victim as Charles Davis. Repeat, Charles Davis.
Yeah. Where? Well, you get a hold of Sterling, and you bring him out there.
Okay.
Okay. All right, come on.
Look, Sterling, no offense, but I'd appreciate it if you didn't tell anyone I came here with you. You know how some of the fellas at headquarters are.
Don't worry.
You know, the captain at Flippers lit if he knew about this.
George, thanks for your help. I appreciate it.
Good luck, Sterling.
Calling Inspector Wilson. Calling Inspector Wilson. A body has been found at Navy Pier 3. It is believed to be that of one Charles Davis. Please report there. Over.
This is Wilson. I'm on my way.
Well, there's nothing there. All right, take him away.
Well, water has prevented the rigidity common in death, but he isn't swollen like someone who's drowned. From the state of the skin, I'd say he's been dead about less than 24 hours. I'll be able to be more explicit after an autopsy.
Thanks, Doc. Recognize him?
Yeah, he's the fourth member of the gang.
Yeah. Had some papers on him. His name was Charlie. Charlie Davis. Figured he was the one that shot Kelly, just like he did Randolph. Then you shot him, so that closes the circle.
For you, maybe, but not for me. I got something to do.
Where are you going?
To find Charlie, the real Charlie. And talk to a girl.
Go on, I'll see you at home, okay?
Yeah, okay.
Hey, Gary.
Yeah?
Where are you going?
Well, into the city. There's a new bar in Columbus. I'm meeting my girl there.
Give me a lift?
Sure thing. Get in.
Thanks. I'll buy you a drink.
You can't be over 21.
Sure I am. Don't you believe me?
Oh, do I look? Hi, George. Have you seen Betty yet?
No.
She's late.
Scotch, what would you like?
White horse.
White horse.
Telephone, please. Excuse me. Okay. The body was a phony. That's right, but I think I know why. I will. I'll have this all wrapped up by tomorrow night. Meet me at the Valhalla.
Gary.
Betty.
I'm sorry I'm late.
Yeah, sure. Hi, Barbara.
Hi.
Well, goodbye.
Thank you.
was it?
Una pallottola in corpo. Voglio che lei me la tolga, senza perdere un minuto di tempo.
Non sarà facile, specie se prima non si localizza il proiettile.
Avanti, me la tolga.
Non posso, prima devo avvertire la polizia per le ferite d'arma.
Coraggio!
Va bene, si tolga la giacca e si stenda su quel lettino. L'abbiamo tolto.
Ok. I've got the bullet. I'm finished. If your temperature goes up and you can't stand the pain, take one of the red ones. Take one of the green ones every 4 hours.
Thank you, Doctor.
Relax, Jasmine. Just relax. Nonchalance, nonchalance. Here, give me your hand. I like this. Now, you...
Excuse me.
Hmm?
I'm looking for Janet Mell.
Janet's not working today. And now, I guess we're ready, girls.
Hmm.
Would you buy me a drink? You were asking too many people about me. It began to annoy me. That's why I decided to come in person. Well, I do know Charlie. All I can tell you is everything is finished between us. He left town. Without him, I couldn't stand that apartment. Now I'm alone. A girl alone on a holiday night. What would you like to know about me? You want to know how many men I've had? It's funny, all men want to know the same thing. Charlie was different. He was with me and that was enough. He gave me a sense of security. And he made me forget. What do you think a girl my age wants? To waste her life like that? To count the years that go by? And then what she got left? No, Sterling. I want to live. I want to live every single day as if it were my last day on Earth.
No, don't go. I feel no, no, no. I say, hey.
You know, I'm just mad about this place. Come on. Oh, I want to dance.
Be a little kind to me. Take a look.
Come on, don't just stand there. Cheer up, huh?
For the blonde. You can find her on the phone. Hear your story.
If you're following me, in order to know the end, get ready because it's near. Very near.
Hi.
Hi.
Let's go away. Do you mind? I want to be alone with you, all right? As you can see, it's not much, but it's the only place I can call my own. Come on. Come. Make yourself comfortable. What are you thinking about?
You?
Is that a compliment?
No.
That's what I thought. Why don't you forget it? Why don't you go away? Go away.
Charlie, you brought him here so he could kill me. So when he comes, I want him to see us like this. Call for Marengo's worked, and you fell into your own trap. This is your bag, setting people up. Like when you had Rocky killed, and you fixed it so I got kicked off the force. So you'd have a free hand knocking over the factory. But I saw Kelly, and I saw Randolph. And you remember everything that was said at the factory.
Oh, Nicky, we're going away. We're going to start all over.
Hey, do you know that you're getting bigger all the time? Kill my son, and I'll never forgive that. Yeah, Charlie, but I've always known you as Gary.
It was a mistake. That bullet was for you. It was a mistake.
Stop it. Let him go or I'll kill you.
Don't give him the gun. You know too much, he'll kill you. Get away while you can. Leave me alone with him.
Shut up, Fuzz. Stay where you are.
You paid the rent to Janet's apartment. And there's a receipt to prove it. You paid it with your father's allowance check. And you endorsed it. Rocky knew it.
He's only bluffing. Shut your trap.
Now O'Neill knows it.
You're lying.
Ask her. He was in the club with me.
It's true, Charlie. He was with me.
You shut up and stay where you are.
I've got a gun and I'm going to use it. This will be the last chance for you to get out of here. You better take advantage of it.
Janet, don't move.
You better go, Janet.
Don't move, stupid.
What are you waiting for? Get out.
Don't try it, Sterling.
Oh!
How is he, Doctor?
We'll take care of him. He'll be all right. It's not too serious.
Your story. Don't be too hard on him.